Hi, this is Meghdeep Bose, and you're watching me on Cine Speaks.
So, you have been working with your father for five long years. What was your experience working with your father?
It was a kind of complicated stuff because, first of all, he's your father, but also he's your client. And to maintain that balance, it was a little tough because, you know, there were personal fronts as well as professional fronts intermingled into each other. But then over the time, I could strike a balance between the two. And of course, with the ocean of talent my dad has, I could learn a lot of things and I could move ahead in life.
Okay, so if you had a great set of songs with Amal sir, and you had a super hit song with him, the Mehu Hero Tera. So what was the experience that you had with Amal sir?
Actually, with Amal, not just Mehu Hero Tera, but many other songs that we've collaborated on, Amal gives me a very free hand on producing songs for him. And every time he has to change the sound, he has to, you know, bring out a new sound of his songs. He just entrusts me with the song. He says that do your thing on the song. He never limits me into any sort of foundation and everything.
Okay.
So working with Amal is a lot of fun. Also because we are of the same generation, but the kind of souls we are, you know, we are young bloods. But we are classic soul, you know. So the point is our tastes also gel a lot, you know, are very similar.
Yeah.
So when we work together, our school of thoughts never have a conflict. We often end up on the same line of thought.
Okay.
And that's what makes our work a lot of fun.
And how about Shankar Ehsaan Loy or Pritam sir?
So Shankar Ehsaan Loy, Pritam Da, Salim Suleiman, Clinton Sergio, all these guys have been, they are like one generation above us, you know.
Yeah.
We've actually grown up listening to them.
So
every time I've worked with them, I've worked with them with a learning, with a spirit of learning that, you know, whenever I'm in the studio with them, I'll get to learn something, you know, I'll get to learn something new. Or even if I'm meeting them up, it's always about taking something back home that you learned from them.
Okay.
So, working for them has been a dream come true because we've grown up listening to them, we've grown up on their music, we've been influenced by their music. In that case, sharing the studio space with the same people who you've inspired in life, you know, who you've been inspired by in life, is a great honor, you know. So it's been a terrific experience of whatever amount of time I've worked with.
Does that bring any sort of pressure on you while making songs or while...
Honestly, once you get into the zone of creating music, more than pressure, it's a thrill for me, you know, because you are delivering something that has not been done before. You know? If a composer has called you in the studio to produce something, it means that the composer wants your essence on the track. So all you need to do in the studio is to be yourself, you know, because if you try to imitate those composers that who have already, if you try to deliver what you've been thinking the composers would expect, you know, would be a little stupid. But then to really live up to the song is the duty of a music producer, where, you know, when a composer calls you, you need to just be yourself, you know, because that is what they've called you for.
Yeah.
They've always called you to collaborate. It's a collaborative act. Whenever a composer calls a producer to produce, it's a collaborative act. So being yourself is a challenge also. You know, it's like, because there are so many influences, so many thoughts crossing your mind while you're producing a piece of music. So it's more of a thrill for me more than a pressure.
So what is your first thought when you go for some composition? What is your first thought?
As a composer, honestly, there is no deliberate thought behind composing. You know, it's a very organic thing. You know? It's like language. Music is like a language. It is a language, you know. And when you speak, you don't think about the words, right? You speak it out. Music is pretty much the same. It happens, you know. There's no deliberate plan, deliberate thought behind it. You know? You don't put a thought behind it. It happens to you. It comes out because you know that you know about the situation that you're composing for, you know what you're composing for, who you're composing for, what would be the audience that you're catering to, what does your client want. So all these things actually consolidate into your thought process. And music is something which cannot be controlled, which is not deliberate. So music has to happen, you know. And so to answer your question that what is the thought process, there is no thought process actually.
Okay.
It happens when you've thought enough.
You know, okay.
It's when you stop thinking. That is when music happens. You know.
You had worked on the national as well as on international songs as well. So what, working on international songs, what extra efforts do you pursue?
Actually, there are no extra efforts. Again, when you go international, the first thing you need to remember is that you're representing India. You know, you're representing Indian music, you know. So our Indian musicians' tendency is to sound like the Western people, you know.
Mm.
But when you go international, your basic effort is to sound Indian, you know, because that is where a collaboration would happen, you know, because you are on the world map, and you need to stay up for the place you're representing. So the basic thought, the basic rule of thumb when you're collaborating internationally is that to understand the sensibilities of the Western people, of the Western musicians, but have the roots down here in India, you know. That's how you actually go international. Where being international is not about how beautifully you can create Western genres. It's about how beautifully you blend it into Western genres, keeping your Indian roots alive.
Absolutely true. So right now there's a trend of rap songs and remixes.
Mm.
Do you think that in this generation, in this rap generation, somewhere but down the line, the old melodies are getting spoiled or something like that?
See, absolutely, it cannot be absolutely answered in a yes or a no, because music always follows the trend. You know, music has always been evolving. You know, we humans have been evolving. A person who dresses in a particular manner in 2000s wouldn't have been dressing in 1970s, you know.
Mm.
So just like our clothes, just like our living styles, just the way we live our lives, also our music changes, you know. And as far as raps and other genres are concerned, it is just a part of the evolution, you know, and we should welcome it with open arms, because definitely music is like a big garden. You cannot have just one colored flowers in the garden. You need different colors for a beautiful image to come out. So I think it's a part of the evolution. It's a part of change, and we should welcome it, you know. And definitely, as far as melody is concerned, a melody won't lose its place in the common man's mind, in the common man's heart, because that is what any human connects to, you know. So definitely melody cannot be lost. It cannot lose its importance ever. The only thing is that the influence of other genres is something that needs to be handled very sensibly. If a change comes in more beautifully, it's most welcome.
Okay. So tomorrow is Music Day, celebrated throughout. So do you think that there is a need to celebrate a Music Day, because music and songs are something a person pursues in its everyday life? So is there a need to celebrate a special day?
See, it's very subjective again, you know, because every day you live your life, right? You're born on just one day. So it's totally on you whether you celebrate every day or whether you celebrate just one day. It's just about if Music Day is, I would say, interpreted as a day for musicians to come together and do something meaningful, definitely the Music Day should happen, and it should happen on larger scales, you know, if the musician community comes together and if it helps binding them close together. I think it's a very beautiful thing to happen.
Okay. Lastly, if you ever get the chance or get the opportunity to work with Badshahs or to collaborate with Badshahs or on a rap song, would you pursue it? Or
I would love to, because Badshah is a fantastic songwriter, you know, and the way he thinks, the way he envisions his song, and I think Badshah also has really good vibes, you know, whenever I've heard his stuff. I really love his courage, you know, it's fantastic. So yes, I've been following Badshah's works, and if ever there's a collaboration that happens, I would love to be a part of it.
Okay, and can you tell us something about your future projects?
So I'm working on Vishal Shekhar's Bharat, okay. Which is coming next year. We're working on the music right now. I'm working on Student of the Year 2 again for Vishal Shekhar. I'm working on a film called Ila for Amit Trivedi.
Okay.
And I'm working for a couple of songs with Amal again.
Okay.
For a couple of films. The film is unnamed yet, so not sure of the film's name, but yes, I'm working on a couple of songs with Amal. And yes, I'm about to begin on a film score for Mr. Raju Singh. And plus, I'm composing a lot of web content. There's this one web series I'm composing right now, which would be telecasted in July.
Okay.
So,
could you tell us something about that web series?
I'm not supposed to reveal much about it right now, but I will definitely speak about it soon, as soon as the content is out.
Okay, thank you so much for joining with us.